Amen. And giving honor first and foremost to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We are the Apostolic Church of the Lord Jesus Christ, a whole true gospel church based upon the apostle doctrine we hear this evening with another addition to questions and answers with the apostle. As always, it is not the intent of this program to change anyone's religious belief, but we come, Lord God, this evening into your homes to share with you the good news regarding the gospel of Jesus Christ. This evening, if it is the Lord's will, we shall be talking about unrighteousness. Being unrighteous and what God Almighty have left for the body of Christ. We understand and we acknowledge that sin is in the hearts of us all. But at times in our lives, we must learn how to combat it. And at times, we must learn how to cast it aside. Sometimes when people tell us about a word called sin and the things that we are doing, we want to get angry. We want to get upset. First thing that a person wants to do when someone tells them, or should I say, push the wrong button, they want to say, well, you sin also. But yet and still, they don't want, Lord God, to adhere to what the Word of God says. Understand this. We or any other ministry cannot control what you do. Our job is to make you uncomfortable and telling you, Lord God, that the things that you are doing is opposition to what the Word of God have left us. Whether or not we believe in the Word of God, or whether or not we believe if there's a God or not, one thing we do know for sure is that you are going to die one day. And when we die, we're going to find out that everything that folks been telling you from the beginning of our lives, and that these things were so. In 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter and 3rd verse says, for if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, whom the God of the world has blinded the minds of them which believe it not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, whom is an image of God, shall least shine upon them. God is not interested in whether or not, Lord God, you adhere to his word. He have set the foundation. We must build on a foundation that he have laid. Let me make something clear and sure to you. God don't need none of us. We need to understand that we are only on this earth for a short period of time, and we are going to have to move on to the other side. No matter what you consider the other side is, you're going to move to that place. But I can assure you, when you close your eyes for the very last time, that your life is going to be held accountable. For he said in the book of John, the 6th chapter and the 48th verse, Bible say the word going to judge you in the last day. 2 Peter 1st chapter in the 19th verse, he said, for we have a more sure word of prophesying. Bible say, whereby you do good to take heed as a light that shines in a dark place, my Lord, and the day star arise in your heart. Bible say, knowing this, that no prophecy of the scripture is given by any private interpretation. For the prophecy came not by the will of men, but the holy men of God spake as they was moved by the Holy Ghost. God don't care whether or not you believe his word or not. God don't care whether or not, Lord God, you, Lord God, be obedient to his word. God is not interested in. He already came down. He died, and he, Lord God, shed his blood to give us an opportunity, us who want to do better. Us who's interested in the Word of God, because your sins shall certainly find you out one day. Many people, Lord God, is out there sinning rampantly. We're going to come out of 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter, in the 9th verse. And the Bible said, Lord God, in the Word, He said, know ye not. Now, you have to take heed to the Word of God. The Bible said, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not enter into the kingdom of God. Now, whether or not you believe that or not, well, I don't believe that. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what you believe. It doesn't matter, Lord God, what you are taught. The Word of God is going to stand all by itself. The Word of Jesus said in His Word, He said, heaven and earth shall pass away. But God said, my word is settled. We are going to have to answer to every word that God Almighty have left. He said, know ye not that the unrighteous, my Lord, shall not enter into the kingdom of God. So if you have, Lord God, you're righteous and you don't go to church, you don't believe in going to church, you don't believe in Lord God in the biblical aspects of the Bible, then when you die, you're unrighteous. You can't go to heaven. It doesn't matter what you think. You see, people, Lord God, say, well, I don't believe. Who are you? The Bible was here before you was born. And the Bible's going to be here after you die. People will say, well, when was the Bible, Lord God, made? The Bible said, if you read the Word of God in John, the first chapter, the first verse, He said, in the beginning was the Word of God. So when was the Bible here? In the beginning. Before any of us was here, we get this false sense of security. We, Lord God, who walk in flesh, we, Lord God, who are nothing in the eyes of God, we think that God need us. Baby, God don't need nothing we got. He said, God stretched forth the heaven alone all by Himself. He don't need nothing that we got. He has given us an opportunity to come to Him. That's why He said, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not enter into the kingdom of God. That's the Word of God. 2 Peter 1, chapter 19, verse. We have to understand, we talked about that one earlier, but what I'm trying to get you to understand is because you choose not to believe, does not make it right. If you're unrighteous, you decide, I'm not going to church. I'm not going to do none of the sacraments that God has left for the body of Christ. I'm going to live my life. I'm going to do what I want to do. That's your right. That's your life. The Bible says, God said He's long-suffering, not willing that any man should perish, but that all men should come into repentance. God is here, but God is constantly calling us, according to Matthew's the 11th chapter and the 25th verse. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor with a heavy laden. And God said, I will give you rest. He said, take my yoke upon you. And God said, learn of me. For He said, He is meek and lowly in heart, and He will give us rest into our souls. It doesn't matter what you believe. Lord God, you're going to die one day. And when you die and you close your eyes for the last time, you're going to get a clear understanding what is this all about. You have different churches, different ministry, different, Lord God, people out there who's, Lord God, bringing forth the Word of God, trying to open up, as Peter said in 1 Peter 3rd chapter, he said, it's needful for me to, Lord God, put you in remembrance of these things. It's needful, baby. You are going to die one day. You can play with a lot of things. You can play, Lord God, all you want. You can play hopscotch. You can play mud cakes. You can do whatever you want, but you're going to leave this earth one day. And in all this time that you wasted your time on things that is insignificant, then you're going to get an understanding when you roll your eyes over in that pit of hell. Lord God, where fire is going to be all around you. You're going to get a clear understanding that is talked about in the book of Luke, the 16th chapter, the rich man and Lazarus. You may not believe it right now, but when you roll your eyes over and you close your eyes for the last time, all you folks who talk about you don't believe in God, that's a fool. The Bible says only a fool would say there is no God. Lord God, God is real. Lord God, God is the keeper of our souls. Our souls are going to have to answer, Lord, to our God. In the Ecclesiastes, the 12th chapter and the 13th verse, he said, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Bible says, fear God, my goodness, and keep His commandments, For he said, for this is the whole duty of man, for God shall bring every secret work into judgment, whether it be good, Lord God, or whether it not be bad. What a wonderful God we serve that he talks about in Galatians, the fourth chapter, in the fourth verse. He said, when the fullness of time came, God sent forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that was under the law, that we may have adoptionship of the son, that we, Lord God, have an opportunity to live forever. You're not living right now. You think you, Lord God, are living right now? How you living right now when you got to die? I often ask people, how you figure you living? You're not living. I'm living. You're not living. How you living when you got to die? You only live, Lord God, when you're with Jesus. Bible said unrighteous. You're not getting into the kingdom of God. But God put some, he gave us some other things on this scripture. He said, neither thieves. Let me read in 1 Corinthians 6, chapter 9. He said, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God. But look what God said. Be not deceived. Be not deceived. He said, neither fornicators. You out there, my Lord, fornicators. You out there getting your groove on, getting your freak on. Abusing your body. Lord God, letting the devil make mockery out of you. Bible say you out there and you living that lifestyle. You ain't going no heaven. I don't care if you go to church. I don't care if you're a preacher. I don't care who you are. If you are a fornicator, God said, be not deceived. Look what God said. Be not deceived. A fornicator shall not enter into the kingdom of God. Titus, the first chapter in the 10th verse. He say, follow peace. My God, with all means, he said, holiness without. My goodness, holiness without. No man shall see God. You can fool yourself all you want. You can think because, you know, you out there getting your freak on, you ain't married. Hitting everything out there. And Lord God, you think you're living. All you're doing is being played a fool. And the devil is playing you like a funky piano, and you, Lord God, running to it. You're out there committing fornication, and on Sunday you trampling in the church, Lord God, you singing, talking about Mason. You're going straight to hell when you die. It doesn't matter. God is not. Well, God said, he said, when I said unto one, he said, I said unto all, God is not, hear me real good, if you don't learn nothing else tonight, God is not going to change his divine plan to suit you. Understand that we have to come in compliance of this thing. God is not going to change it because he already said in Romans, the 10th chapter and the 15th verse, is written in the volume of the book. It's already here. You can't erase it. We are going to have to line up with every Lord God point that God said. He said, be not deceived. A fornicator shall not enter into the kingdom of God. You know you're not married. You're out there sleeping with these different men. You know you're not married. You're out there sleeping with all these different women. You're not going to heaven if you die. I don't care what the preacher tell you. I don't care what you say. God is bigger than the preacher. God is bigger than anyone who is out there. God gonna put you in hell. See, I need to wake you up. I need to make you uncomfortable. Because you've been out there, Lord God, and you, Lord God, thinking that you, Lord God, are living with this woman or you're living with this man. And just because you go to church and the preacher tell you, oh, Lord, you can ask for forgiveness. He's a lie. You're still a Lord God fornicator. You're still, Lord God, doing wrong. God going to still put you in hell. So if you have given up and say, well, I'm going to go to hell, then go to hell outright. But let me give you a good word of advice here. Ain't no sense in you going to church if you're doing all that foolishness. Why pay your way to go to hell? Stop going. Get your freak on and die like a dog and go to hell, because that's what God going to do. When you die like a dog, because you are going to die like a dog, and he's going to put your dog-liking butt straight in the pit of hell. He said, God, look what God said, be not deceived. Why you want to be deceived? You think God's word don't mean anything to everybody? You think God's word only cover a certain class of people? God's word covers us all. We all must line up. The Bible says in Hebrews the 12th chapter, we're covered, surrounded by so great a cloud of witness. All those men and women who, Lord God, died before us. All those men and women who set the foundation, Lord God, who lived this life, who God Almighty wrote this book to show us how we should behave and how we should, Lord God, conduct ourselves with God. You're out there, Lord God, living with another man. And you got some of them out there who married. The Bible says, need not be that a, Lord God, an adulterer shall not enter into the kingdom of God. Men and women out there got a husband and a wife. Well, I'm going to go and give me a little side piece. Well, God going to put you in hell. Well, you know, woman say, well, you did it, so I'm going to go do it. God going to put you in hell. You can do all you want. You can play all you want. See, Lord, let me give you old saying go. You know, we all been down that old road. The Bible says, you know, we all, the people who saved was once just like you are. But God was merciful to us. We found ourselves. We surrender, Lord God, to God and begin to do the things that God Almighty have asked us to do. The Bible says, he whom God have sent will speak the word without measure, going to tell you the truth. Because the weapon of our warfare, what I'm talking to you today is not carnal, but is mighty through God. Pulling down the strongholds. I'm going to tell you you're going to go to hell. Casting down every imagination. Telling you that preacher, the liar, he's going to hell with you. And everything that exalts themselves against the knowledge of God. God going to put us all in hell if we don't line up with this. No man is above this thing. God Almighty came. He died, Lord God. Even the Jews, when Pilate wanted to let him go, Pilate said, behold this man. Lord God, Pilate asked the Lord God, the Jews, he said, what should I do with he that is called Christ? What should I do with your king? Jews do just like we saying today, crucify him. I don't want him. You saying the same thing, laying up with some other man's wife, laying up in bed with another man's wife. Women, Lord God, laying up in bed with another woman's husband and know it. And then they crawl out of bed. Let me say that again. They crawl out of bed like a worm. And crawl, Lord God, into the church and talk them. I want to get talking about they saved. Man, God's seen it. The Bible says the stone in the wood around your house cry out to God and tell God what you're doing. You ain't got away with nothing. God just letting you do your thing because, you know, death, my God, is going to make everything right. He said, know you not that the unrighteous, those that are not saved. Lord God, I have been baptized. Let me give you a look. If you ain't been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, I don't care what your church say. I don't care what your denomination say. I don't care who your pastor is. I don't care how many people you have in your church. I don't care how long the church been in existence. The church of devil been in the since the days of, when Cain slew Abel. That's what church you belongs to, because if you haven't been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, according to Acts, the second chapter in the 38th verse, God going to put you in hell when you die. I don't care who you think you are. I don't care how much money you got, who you think you are, what you think you are. God is going to put you in hell. I know you don't like hearing this. I know you don't like hearing this because it's necessary for us to stir you up. It's necessary for me to make you uncomfortable because you thinking that God is going to change his divine word to suit you. But if you have not, that's the preacher. I don't care the president. I don't care the Lord God. Whatever Lord God offers you hold, God says, what I said unto one, he said, I said unto all, if you haven't been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, help yourself. Bible said, be not deceived. God going to put you in there. You already did. You know what the Bible called folks who haven't been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ? There's a scripture in the book of Jude, the 12th verse. God called you twice dead. You plucked up by the roots. You know what happened when you plucked something out of the root? You know when you take a plant and you pluck it up out of the root and you throw it down? That plant going to die. God called you raging waves of the sea. God called you foaming out of your own foam. Wandering stars whom reserve the blackness of darkness forever. God got a place for those that don't want him. Now, if you don't want him, you like the Jews said, you know what the Jews said? I don't want him. Just like you saying, I don't want God. That's all right. God said, that's okay. You don't have to have me, but you're going to die. You see, I love that portion of the gospel. I love that part. Oh, you going to die. I'm going to die. Everybody going to die. But what are you doing to prepare yourself for that day? You ain't been baptized. You're going to certainly die. And God going to put you in hell. Now, God is talking to those, when we talk about 1 Corinthians 6 and 9, he's talking to those that have been baptized. People who, Lord God, been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, my Lord, according to Acts, the 2nd chapter and the 38th verse. Some has been filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost. And some, Lord God, walk according to John, the 4th chapter and the 24th verse, where he say, God is a spirit. And those that will worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. Understand there are people out there who've been baptized and filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost. Out there sleeping with another man's wife. Some woman sleeping with another man's husband. People out there who's single. Lord God sleeping around. These people are already been saved. And God is going to still put them in hell with you who choose not to be saved. He said, be not deceived, neither an adulteress nor effeminate. There's a word called effeminate. I talked about this last week about a word called homosexual and lesbian. People, that's another thing that people don't like to be uncomfortable with. I love to make people uncomfortable. The Bible talking about even an effeminate. You got a man walking around twisting his butt like a woman. A man is deceiving his mind, thinking he's a woman. God called that an effeminate. God going to put you in hell. You can go out there and have your breast augmentation all you want. You can get your cheeks did all you want. When you finish, God going to put you in hell because you are going to die. It's written in the volume of the book. You can't get away from this thing. You, Lord God, either have to line up with it, Lord God. See, folks don't want you to talk about these things. But remember, to be silent about it means you go along with it. So therefore, our responsibility in the gospel of Jesus Christ is to do like Lord God, Hagar said, I'm on my watch. I'm on my job. I love you enough to tell you what thus saith the Lord, thou Redeemer. God said, who formed thee from the womb? God said, I am he who spreadeth forth the earth all by myself. God don't need us. We must come into compliance. He said, neither thieves, nor covenants, or drunkards. Oh, out there drinking your liquor, your wine, Lord God, getting your party on. You're not going to heaven. I had a preacher just a couple of weeks, just Sunday. Went out, Lord God, and talking about he was going to do all this fancy stuff. Went out there, and the first thing he do is pull out a beer. You know what we did? We left. He pulled out a beer, a preacher. Lord God, drunken out there, Lord God, called himself a man of God. And we have to show God respect. I put one foot in front of another, and I walk right out of there. You out there, you drinking, you licking your wine on the side. Preacher, Lord God, said, getting a nip. God going to put you, don't get a nip. Get it all, baby, because God going to put you in hell with it. Ain't no sense you nipping if you don't want to do this thing according to the word of God. God going to put you there. You can drink your beer. You can drink your wine. You can make whatever excuse, whatever lie you want to get, Lord God, your drink on all you want. When you die, God going to put you in hell with your alcohol. And that's a fact. You know, the word of God says, neither drunkards, nor revelers, nor extortion shall inherit the kingdom of God. Now, if you can't get into the kingdom of God, what else left for you? So get your drink on, get your freak on, get out there and do everybody you want to do. Lord God, get your smoke on, all your drugs on, do everything you want to do, because when you do these things, you're going to get caught one time. And God's going to kill you. And he's going to put you in hell. You have many preachers drinking in the pulpit. You have many preachers who's committing fornication and adultery in the pulpit. You have many preachers out there who let a lot of things go on in the church. And many of you all know it's wrong and know about it, but you stay there anyway. Bible say, be not partakers, my God, of another man's sin. Something wrong with the world. But God Almighty is sure. God Almighty is coming back, Lord God, for a church without a spot or wrinkle. 1 Peter 4 chapter, Lord God, in the 18th verse. For he said, for if the righteous scarcely be saved, my God, those that are doing the will of God, those that are doing everything that they know for God, those that are being obedient, those who are out there who ain't getting their freak on like you getting your freak on and you crawling, you crawl into church and get on your knees and say, God, please forgive me. You think God's stupid? I don't understand people. You think God is stupid? You think God gonna, Lord God, just forgive you, Lord God, of your mess when you have not yet even been baptized? Look what he said in John, the first chapter, the 19th verse. When Jesus healed a man from being blind. And when they brought him to the Pharisee kept asking him questions about it. Then the man just got tired. And he said, we know that God hear not the prayers of a sinner. Now, what is a sinner? Someone ain't been baptized yet. You was born into sin, Psalms 51:5. We was all born into sin. He said, for we know that God hear not the prayers of a sinner. But if a man be a worshiper of God and do his will, he will hear. Now, if you ain't been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, I hate to bust your little bubble today, but I'm going to pop it. God don't even know who you are. God don't even know who you are. You can get on your knees, baby, and tell it bleed. You can cry out to God from the bottom of your heart to the top of your tongue. God ain't heard a word you say. Because why? You don't belong to him. He don't even know who you are. My Lord, my God. They said, Lord, they said, Lord, in your name, we have done many wonderful works. In your name, Lord God, we open up churches. In your name, Lord God, we sing in the choir. In your name, Lord God, we preach in the pulpit. In your name, Lord God, we feed the hungry. In the name, we do all these things. You know what God said? He said, depart from me, ye that work of iniquity. Look at God said.